Well, it's week six, and by now you may have found the perfect one that has kept you up at nights. Now, if you have seen enough homes and are ready to make an offer on the home of your dreams, keep in mind that a written and signed, a ratified purchase offer can bind both you and the seller. Now, this is where your real estate agent is very important. They're going to guide you. They're going to advise you and help you keep your goals in mind. Now, you have to trust in your agent and go over all the details. You'll probably have several contingencies, like a home inspection, a pest inspection, an appraisal, and a closing date. Now, these are just as important as the offer price. So, pay close attention as your agent is your negotiator. Now, your agent may want you to sweeten the offer. Maybe it's an unusual request, such as writing a letter to the sellers, doing a video explaining what you love about the home and why it's perfect for your family. Even rent backs may help you succeed. Now, these are allowances for the seller to rent back the home after closing for a short period of time while they close on their next home. In this seller's housing market, many homes are receiving multiple offers and some even over asking price. So you need to do whatever it will take to set your offer apart from the rest to get accepted. Now your agent will be a great resource for this. Now if you're accepted, it's called in contract, as you are now bound to the agreement between you, the buyer, and the seller. You will be asked to write a check for the earnest money. Now this is why it was so important to make sure your funds are accessible last week. The earnest money is usually refundable if the contingencies are not met by the seller or the home. Now make sure you understand every detail of your contract. Okay, so now you should have an offer accepted and you're in contract. Now, the clock starts ticking down to that closing date. If you have followed this process and responded quickly to your lender and real estate agent, you should be in good shape to close on time or even early. Now please watch my video on do's and don'ts when you're in contract. It's important to keep the status quo on your finances, job, and marital status. Now remember to keep communications open, be responsive, and congratulations. I'll see you on week 7.